Helgen, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview on WWE.com. We are awaiting our guest this week, the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar, who will face Dean Ambrose and Roman Reigns in a triple threat match Sunday on the WWE Network to determine who goes to WrestleMania to face... Hello, Mr. Heyman.
Sir.
We are actually awaiting the arrival of your client, Brock Lesnar, who you could bring in at any time.
You got him.
No, we're actually ready for Brock. We're all set up.
You got him.
Paul.
Sir.
Brock is very muscular.
Yes, he is.
He's much bigger than you.
I don't need to hear about your fetishes. Yes, I'm aware of that.
So you're going to speak for Brock in this interview.
Wow, there's a cherry.
Okay, let's get started. Dean Ambrose. He just won't go away, will he?
He's like a gnat.
He low-blowed your client.
Indeed he did.
What's Brock going to do to Dean Ambrose?
Brock Lesnar is going to get his hands on Dean Ambrose. He's going to take Dean Ambrose to Suplex City. He's going to F5 Dean Ambrose this Sunday live on the WWE Network at Fastlane. Stack Roman Reigns on top of Dean Ambrose. Defeat them both and go on to WrestleMania to defeat Triple H for the undisputed WWE Heavyweight Championship of the World.
The last time Brock was involved in a triple threat match of this magnitude, it actually started one-on-one at WrestleMania versus Roman Reigns, turned into a triple threat when Seth Rollins cashed in his Money in the Bank contract, and your client lost.
No, my client did not.
Paul, this is an interview.
Hold on a second. Yeah, I got Michael Cole.
Hello, this is an interview, Paul. You're wasting valuable time.
Let me handle this. I'll get back to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
My pleasure, Mr. Cole. Listen, let's get one thing straight, okay? You wanted to interview me. I'm a busy man. Understand I have other obligations.
Paul, I had no interest in interviewing you. Sorry, no disrespect, but I wanted to interview Brock Lesnar.
And you got him.
Okay, can we continue?
WrestleMania last year.
Yes.
I failed Brock Lesnar. I should have anticipated Seth Rollins was going to cash in Money in the Bank. I should have anticipated the move, and I didn't. It was my lack of forethought, it was my lack of foresight that cost Brock Lesnar the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. I'll never make that mistake again.
You do realize that if Brock does not even have to be involved in the decision this Sunday, because Roman could pin Dean and Roman could move on to WrestleMania or vice versa?
We know that walking in the door, though. We didn't realize that walking into WrestleMania last year. Again, my failure to Brock Lesnar. I've made that straight with my client. But we know what we're walking into this Sunday. A triple threat match. Brock Lesnar versus Roman Reigns versus Dean Ambrose. We know the variables. We know the equation. And we know the outcome. Brock Lesnar will win the triple threat match this Sunday and will go on to main event WrestleMania and defeat Triple H for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
Paul, what if Brock Lesnar doesn't win?
If? I don't deal in ifs. I deal in absolutes. What if someone actually listens to your commentary and realizes, holy cow, this guy's on our television show, and they replace you with... Who was it before you? Gordon Solie or whoever that was? Okay? Once they realize who you are, all bets are off. I don't deal in ifs. I deal in absolutes. An absolute. Brock Lesnar is the only athlete in history to be the NCAA Division I Heavyweight Champion, the UFC World Heavyweight Champion, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. I deal in absolutes. If your aunt had a pair, she'd be your uncle. She doesn't, so she's not. She's your aunt. Don't ask me ifs. Ask me absolutes. I've been very candid with you today. I admitted the one failure in my entire career, and then I failed Brock Lesnar at last year's WrestleMania. What a confession I have offered you, and you're not even Ellen DeGeneres. So please, ask me factual questions based on substantive information. Don't ask me ifs.
Can you just humor me and just... Please humor me and
think
about this.
A rabbi, a priest, and a horse walk into a bar. Bartender says, what is this, a joke? There.
What will Brock do if he loses? What will Brock do if he loses?
I can't even conceive that happening. Do you really believe that Roman Reigns or Dean Ambrose stand a chance against Brock Lesnar? And if they team up against Brock Lesnar, it's the end of their friendship because one of them will have to betray the other in order to go on to WrestleMania. They can't go on to WrestleMania together. Somebody has to make a choice here. Somebody has to decide that that championship is worth more than that friendship. Now, either Roman Reigns will make that decision or Dean Ambrose will make that decision. But one of them's going to have to make that decision. We will split them. We will divide them. And then Brock Lesnar will take them both out. And if they gang up on Brock Lesnar, it's fait accompli anyway. They're damned if they do and they're damned if they don't.
If Brock wins.
If.
What happens?
When Brock wins.
What happens at WrestleMania?
Well, then Triple H is going to be exposed as a trophy husband and he's going to go down at the hands of the most decorated athlete in the history of sports entertainment or sports entertainment, Brock Lesnar.
Thank you, Paul.
That's it.
That's it.
Nothing else.
Nothing else.
The best you got.
I do have one other question.
Please. Is it an if or is it factual?
Why do you like me?
Why don't I like you?
Yeah.
It's personal. It's just an assessment of your character as a man. And probably a little bit professional, too, just based on what I've heard of your commentary.
Thanks. At least you were honest about that.